you really can't compare the fun and excitement you can have out on the water with one of these electric or nitro-powered boats from Pro Boat Models. They come out of the box completely ready to run. They're really user-friendly, but there's one step that just about everybody overlooks when they go to run their boat for the first time, or for the first time in a season, or before they're going to put it away for the season, and that is properly lubricating and maintaining your flex shaft. We're going to walk you through the steps on what you need to do to go ahead and do that on this Formula FASTech boat that you have here. To go ahead and perform this basic maintenance, you're going to need some simple tools. First of all, for this boat itself, we need a 2.5 millimeter Allen wrench, a 5.5 millimeter nut driver, a set of channel locks, a set of vice grips, and of course, your marine grease gun. Pro Boat sells this in one convenient package where it's the grease itself with the gun mechanism on the end. Just works really simple. So let's dive into this. We've got, like I mentioned, the Formula FASTech brushless here, and I've started some of the disassembly process already. So let's dive underneath the canopy here and we'll take a look. Inside the hull, you've noticed I've already kind of started the disassembly process. One thing I'm going to do here as well is I'm going to unplug the motor connections from the speed controller just to keep the wires out of the way. And what I'm interested in is this part right here. Let's come at it from this side. What you'll need to do is loosen up the collet that retains the flex shaft and connects it to the motor. Basically, this part here is stationary, closest to the motor. This is the part here that you'll have to loosen up. So I've already done that, and as you can see, just slides right out of place. And you can see there's kind of a groove here too. That's just kind of where the collet keeps everything together. Now that we have the collet loosened that retains the flex shaft, we're going to need to remove the flex shaft from the rear of the boat. On this boat, what I've done is I've removed one of the 2.5 millimeter screws here so I can actually swing that up and out of the way. The next step is I'm going to need to remove this screw and that nut. This is, again, you'll need a 2.5 millimeter Allen wrench and a 5.5 millimeter nut driver. Now for this, I actually used, I've gotten a ton of these over the years in various different kits. They call it a box wrench or a Tamiya wrench. It's the right size for doing it. It's small enough to get in around the stabilizers and everything. So we'll back that off, and there's the nut off. Pull the screw out and set those aside. And now this whole unit is going to slide out as one piece. Now here's your flex shaft. You may find it handy to use rubber gloves while doing this, just because the grease does tend to get thick. Keep an eye too when you have everything apart that you have some tolerance in here for the prop shaft to move in and out. You don't want this to bind up. If you don't have any back and forth movement here, you'll need to loosen up that set screw or that set screw there and then adjust it. Now I do have some seaweed here that I'm going to pull the prop off, clean off in just a second, and then lube everything up. Alright, so now I've got the flex shaft out, and you can even see just the corrosion that's kind of come off on my hands here. It's not a good sign. I should have lubed this a lot earlier than I did. Let's take the grease gun, and I'm just going to squirt a little bit out here. And just kind of take my finger and thumb and work it around the entire flex shaft. That looks to be pretty good. I'm going to set that down here. Now the extra step I'm going to take too is I'm actually going to take the grease gun and squirt some right in the prop shaft tube just to help spread it around a little bit more. And now with that lubed, I can go ahead and slide the flex shaft back in, and you'll feel a little resistance. That's normal because it's not completely smooth anymore. It has that grease. Now here's a main thing to remember when you slide everything back into place, and I'm glad that this didn't do it. So as you can see here, I have my flex shaft reinserted back into the collet. The problem is the collet retaining nut is down below in the hull. You need to make sure when you slide everything through that you actually get that retaining nut, kind of one or two threads onto that nut should make sure that it retains on there for you. So now what we're going to do is I'm actually going to put the retaining nut on first. Sorry for my fat fingers. I have it where it's just caught the first thread and push the flex shaft back through. Now there's a very important step here before you get everything tightened down with the flex shaft collet, and that is you'll need to go ahead and set the depth here of your prop. If you tighten it down to the motor too soon, you can't slide this in and out and get your hole size or get your hole aligned properly. So once you have everything aligned, just slide the screw straight through. Don't forget there should be washers on each side of the screw and on the nut. Grab your nut and put it back on. Now one thing too, I don't have any right here to do it. I'm going to do this before I actually go out and run it for the first time. Put a dab of thread locking compound on the screw before it goes into the nut. That'll just make sure that it doesn't rattle loose on you as you're in the middle of the water. So I'm going to just tighten this down. That's good there. And then the last thing I can do here is reinstall the screw that retains the stabilizer on the side. Back in on there. And now we can properly tighten down the collet. So we grab the main hex with the vise grips and then use our channel locks just to tighten down the collet. And there we have that back reinstalled. So we've got pretty much everything back together, but there is one last spot that you want to pay special attention to. And that's this area here that actually holds and aligns the flex shaft to the flex shaft tube in the hull itself. If you notice, I didn't disassemble this part of the flex shaft to grease it. Well, some of you may be thinking, well, he missed a spot, or some of you others might be thinking, well, I guess I don't have to do that. This is one of the really cool things about this grease gun here from ProBoat, is it has this nozzle here that'll actually go right into that hole on this support. So all you have to do, get everything lined up and give it a squeeze. My recommendation here, turn it just to kind of spread it around, and now we've properly lubed that part of the flex shaft. So there you have it. In just a few simple steps and minutes, we've gone ahead and properly lubed and maintained our flex shaft on our Formula FASTech that we have here. All that's left to do is thread the antenna back up through the antenna tube, put the boat back together, and we're ready to head out to the lake, which is where we're heading very soon. If you do have any comments or questions over anything that we've shown you here today, please feel free to email us at editors@horizonrc.com. Thanks for watching.